In this video, we will again be focusing on the scikit-learn library and how exactly it is used for dataset transformation. So far, we have seen scikit-learn library for supervised learning, how it is used for model selection and evaluation. And in this video, we will see how exactly we will see the scope of scikit-learn library for dataset transformation. Now, for dataset transformation, first we need to know why do we need dataset transformation. As we have mentioned in the previous videos, sometimes it is not possible for us to see or compute a big amount of data, that might be in thousands. So it will be easy for us to calculate quantity that are in ones or tens, but if those things are tens or if those things are in thousands, lakhs, so it will be a difficult for me. So in these cases we use dataset transformation, so that it makes us more viewable for us. It's make it sort of simplifies the way we view our data or we want our algorithm to train on. So in this video, we will talk about how do we transform our dataset through some standard procedures. And apart from that, there are many more data transformation techniques which you can obviously learn from scikit-learn.org. So we'll move ahead and we'll see the techniques which are mentioned in this video. So we'll see. So first of all, I have taken a dictionary, as you can see, measurement. So it has a city is the key, and it has mentioned the name of the city and its temperature. So I'll run this dictionary. So now from the sklearn feature extraction, I have imported dict vectorizer. Now the dict vectorizer can be used to convert feature arrays represented as list of standard Python objects to representation used by scikit-learn estimators, So basically, dict vectorize implement if you have basically the one of one hot encoding for categorical features. So categorical features are attribute value pairs where the value is restricted to a list of discrete possibilities without ordering. So in this, the following city is a categorical attribute while temperature is a traditional numerical feature. So what dict vectorizer will do, it will accept multiple string values for feature multiple categories, and it will assume a database classifies each category, and it will make it more viewable for us. So we'll see ahead and compile this. So I have created an instance of my dict vectorizer. Now you can see, so here we have transformed our data set to an array. So basically you can see now if the city is Dubai, so here it is 1, it is 0, 0. If city is Delhi, if city is London, here it is 1, and for others 2 rows it is 0. If city is San Francisco, here it is 1 and others it is 0. And I have, so in same way I have computed the temperature also. Now suppose if you want to get the feature names, you can get the feature name easily, so easy. Now we'll see the same for other. So now here, so basically, so we saw the what dict vectorizer did. So when we call the get feature name, so what exactly it does is that it will check whether the category belongs to that feature or not. If it doesn't, so it will give us false. So these are some various attributes that are associated with dict vectorizer feature of dict vectorizer transformation technique. You can obviously check out more in the scikit-learn.org. So we'll move ahead and we'll see more. So again, for this example, as you can see, I have initialized, I have converted this to array, and this is something I have initialized as zero. So you can obviously assign weight and those things to the features as per your convenience. Now we'll move ahead and we'll see counter vectorizer. So the counter vectorizer is very interesting feature. So what count vectorizer does is basically convert a collection of text document to a matrix of, you know, token counts. So okay, so first we'll run and we'll see this how exactly you know, it's what exactly it does. Okay, now here you can see we have read a lot of text here. So now what count vectorizer is doing, it is converting a collection of these text document to a matrix of token counts. As you can see, that word sauerkraut is appearing for 14 times, word di is coming 3 times. So this is the why we use count vectorizer, you know, to convert to have a token counts of matrix for our text documents. So this is very interesting feature or technique. Now we'll see pre-processing. So in pre-processing, what we do is, you know, we scale our data. You know, if you want it, as I mentioned, you know, we don't want any feature to have more preference or more you know, more prominence on the outcome than the other. So what we do, we scale the data. Like, for example, you'll see in this code. So what we do, we import our preprocessing, imports NumPy as MP. So I'll just run this. So as you can see, we have preprocessed this. Now if I want to calculate the mean, so here you can see I got the mean. As you can easily see, 1 plus 2 plus 0 divided by 3 is 1. Now if you want to scale, so as you can see, all these are scaled accordingly. You know, they are not that much away from each other. So these are the basically things, you know, which we can obviously do. Now we can go ahead and assign, you know, different weights, you know, through which we can transform our data. For example, now here, as you can see, I have transformed this data, this matrix as this. So again, you can, it's up to you. How exactly do you want your transformation to be? It's completely up to you. There are many ways, you know, through which you can transform your data. And so we'll move ahead and see. So this is our transfer. Now here comes. So basically what happens is that a lot of times in our data, there are missing values. You know, some data is missing. Now, obviously, if some data is missing, it will be not good for us, obviously, because we don't want any data to be missed when we are, you know, training our algorithm. So what we can do is that we can impute data. Now, how, what data to be imputed? You know, it can be the mean of all the values in that feature. It can be the maximum feature that is appearing. It's up to, totally up to you. So we'll see this. So from sklearn, I have imported simple imputer. So it will impute the values which we want. So I'll just run this. Now I have run this. So now for example, now if I run x here now, so you'll see, okay, x is not declared there, so my bad. So first of all, okay, so this is x. As you can see, I have given it a missing value, NaN value, which doesn't have makes any sense. So but now when we run our impute function and we transform it, so we'll see what. So here you can see I have given it in NaN, but right now it's have the value 4. So this is what impute does, you know, it imputes the value, missing value. So now if you want to permanently, now if you run x here, you'll see that, you know, it's the same. Now if you want to permanently make x imputed x, so what you can do is you can assign x here and you can now print x. So now when you will see, No, the x is permanently imploded. So that's it for this video. Thank you.